Hi there. In this video, we will go over the Pythagorean theorem. Some definitions are on the left side of the page. Also, we have some properties of special right triangles. Those special right triangles are 30, 60, 90 degree, and 45, 45, 90 degree triangles. These special triangles show up quite often in trigonometry. Let's try to figure this example out. First, note that it's a right triangle since it has a 90 degree angle. It also has a 45 degree angle in it. So the other angle has to be 45 degrees as well, since the angles have to add up to 180 degrees. This means the two sides connected to the right angle are equal. So we can label it as x2. Then we use the Pythagorean theorem and solve for x. Simplifying and isolating the x squared, we then can use the square root property to solve for the x values. We end up with x being equal to plus or minus 9. But negative 9 cannot work since it is negative, so 9 is the only solution. Also note that this fits the description of a 45, 45, 90 special right triangle on the left. All the sides have a factor of 9 except the hypotenuse. It's multiplied by a square root of 2. Another example. Let's label A, B, and C so we know how to plug it in the Pythagorean theorem. Now we plug the expression into the theorem and solve for x. Distribute the terms to get rid of parentheses. Some music while I write. Now that we got the equation in standard form, we can factor by looking at factors of 5 that add up to negative 6. So negative 5 and negative 1. We get x equals 5 and x equals 1 as our solutions. But x equals 1 cannot be a solution since plugging it in would give 0 for one of the sides. So x equals 5 is the only solution. Next example. Let's label the A, B, and C part of the triangle so we know which side is which. Also notice this is a 30, 60, 90 triangle. So the sides fit the pattern on the left, meaning since the hypotenuse is x, the side B is half of x. Now, let's use the Pythagorean theorem and solve for x. Simplify by squaring all the terms. Let's get rid of fractions in the equation by multiplying both sides by 4. Simplify the terms and isolate the x squared term so we can use the square root property to solve for x. Using the square root property, we have x will equal plus or minus the square root of 324. We end up with plus or minus 18. Only 18 will work since negative 18 doesn't make sense here. Also note that the sides match the property on the left of the 30-60-90 special right triangle. The hypotenuse is 18. So side B is half of that, 9, and side A is the hypotenuse times the square root of 3 over 2, which simplifies to 9 square root of 3. Now let's take a look at the circle in the rectangular coordinate system. On the left, we have the general equation of a circle centered at HK with radius R. On our diagram on the right, we are looking at a circle of radius 1 and centered at the origin 0, 0. This is called a unit circle. This is used all over trigonometry, so know your unit circle and you will know trig. Notice the circle is split into four parts on the rectangular coordinate system. Starting from the upper right, which is quadrant 1, going counterclockwise, the next quadrant is quadrant 2, then quadrant 3, and finally quadrant 4. We use this terminology in trig to describe where possible points and angles may be. Now let's play with this example to find some values of the unit circle. We want to first find the corresponding y values when x is root 3 over 2. So we plug x into our unit circle equation and solve for y. Simplify and isolate the y squared term, then use the square root property to find y. So there are two values of y that correspond to the x value of root 3 over 2, and that is plus or minus 1/2. Let's plot them on the unit circle in our diagram. Notice the first point is in quadrant 1, and the second point is in quadrant 4. Let's do another example. We want to find corresponding y values to x is negative root 2 over 2. Like the previous example, there will be two y values as we can see on the diagram. So let's plug x into our equation and solve for y like the previous example. We end up with y equals plus or minus the square root of 1 over 2, which simplifies to 1 over root 2. As you may have seen in a previous algebra class, we can also rationalize the denominator by multiplying top and bottom by root 2 to get rid of the radical on the denominator. We end up with y equals plus or minus root 2 over 2. And those values are in quadrant 2 and quadrant 3. Next example. Here we want corresponding x values to y equals negative 1/2. Looking at our graph, we can see where it already may be. Looks like it should be at x equal negative root 3 over 2, right? Let's plug in and see. Using the square root property, we indeed see that the two x values are plus or minus root 3 over 2 for y equals negative 1/2. Now let's find the x values that go with y equals root 2 over 2. Again, we may be able to see what x values they are from the graph. Looks like it should be x equals plus or minus root 2 over 2. Let's plug in and find out. There we have it. Y equals root 2 over 2 corresponds to the x values plus or minus root 2 over 2. Now let's look at an example involving coterminal angles. Basically, to find a coterminal angle, we can add or subtract 360 degrees from an angle given. Also, if an angle is positive, we go counterclockwise from the terminal side. We go clockwise from the terminal side if an angle is negative. So for 30 degrees, to find a coterminal angle between 0 and 720 degrees, we simply add 360 degrees to 30 degrees to get 390 degrees. Finding a coterminal angle to 75 degrees between 0 and 720 degrees, we add 360 to 75 and get 435 degrees. An angle coterminal to 110 degrees, adding 360 to 110, we get 470 degrees. Adding 360 to 315 degrees, we get 675 degrees, is an angle coterminal to 315 degrees. Adding 360 to negative 60, we get 300 degrees being coterminal to angle negative 60 degrees. After adding 360 to negative 150, we get 210 degrees coterminal to negative 150 degrees. And we get 135 degrees is coterminal to negative 225 degrees. After doing all those wonderful examples, you may be able to see a pattern on finding coterminal angles. So for 45 degrees, if you add 360 times k, where k is an integer, we have an expression that defines all coterminal angles to 45 degrees. Remember that we can add 360 degrees, which is going counterclockwise, or subtract 360 degrees, which is clockwise, to find coterminal angles.